want to welcome you to Where Else? This is the Power of Jim. I'm Jim T. Chong, the Wok Star, and I'm a financial professional as well as a media specialist and publicist. And I'm with the incredible, miraculous
Jim Meyer from Remax Gold, and we are with Catherine Moy, who has some breaking news. Take it away, Catherine.
Well, good evening. I do have breaking news, and for some people, this will probably get their hair up. We in Fairfield, and this has not been in the news, the city council unanimously voted to make the sales of marijuana legal inside the city of Fairfield. And that means a few things, and we can go through it. But first, what it means is within the next year, what you're going to see are probably two dispensaries, retail, if you will, of marijuana in our city. And we still are going to choose where it is and how it is, but we're only allowing two for now.
And now you told me that the city of Fairfield has been thinking about this for a long time, and they did some research. They actually hired a private independent company to study this, and this was the independent impartial company of I think it's called Jones, Cheech and Chong, and yeah. They researched it and they said, let's go for it.
They are actually work with many other governments, and we have been looking at it since the voters agreed to this several years ago now. And we said a flat no at first. We wanted to do our own research. We wanted to do what the voters wanted, but we also want to always, number one, with me and with my colleagues, is to make sure that our town is safe. And so the second thing that's really important about this is in November, we will have on our ballot, when you go to vote in the presidential election, you'll have on your ballot whether we want to tax anybody who sells anything per sale. So we have, it'll be a sales tax on marijuana. And I highly suggest, even though I'm a really anti-tax person, in this case, you want to tax it. We have to, because there will be impacts. Our police have to go over plans. It's very, very intricate, but the tax is needed to make sure that we are covering everything that it does. Plus, it'll help our general fund. So,
well, let me ask you this. This is kind of interesting, this whole thing, ever since, for many years, and it's been legalized at a federal level. Okay. Now, here's where it gets a little sketchy. Okay. Yes, it's okay. But on a state level, in some places, it's illegal, right? So,
wait, on a federal level, it's still illegal.
At the federal level, it is not legal.
Okay. I'm sorry. You're right. I got that wrong. At the state level, it's legal, but it's also selective even. I mean, when they say it's legal, I'm trying to decide what that really means, because, okay, state level, legal, but federal level, not legal, but federal level could, you know, just have jurisdiction and override it. So don't you think that's just a little confusing?
It's very confusing. So when it was made when it was made in the state to be legal, it meant that people can use it, but only in their own homes or in their friends' homes. You can't smoke it publicly, just like you can't go outside really and drink whiskey while you're walking down the street or to the park. You can get permits to that at a certain time, but with marijuana, it's very different. You can use it in your home. You can grow up to 6 plants, I believe it is, inside your home. You can't grow any plants outside. So, but in Fairfield, we made it illegal to sell it. And you can do that city by city or by, you know, the county and the unincorporated areas. So we made it so it was illegal. So this is brand new in Fairfield.
So as of tonight, legal to sell marijuana in Fairfield, California.
That's correct. Vacaville, it's still illegal. Vallejo.
How confusing is that?
Huh?
How confusing is that?
Yeah, Vallejo, it is legal already. Dixon, legal. Susan City, they're trying to get their first dispensary up. Then, let's see, Dixon, it is legal. So it's hodgepodge. And let's make this even more confusing. People in Fairfield are already getting marijuana delivered to them. So you can sit in your Fairfield home. I could do it right now. Call one of these delivery services, sales, and they bring it to your door. So, and we're not getting any tax money out of it. So how stupid is that? Okay. Rio Vista. We can have it delivered from Rio Vista. In Rio Vista, you can buy already. They have one big one there, a retail site that sells it. So we are going along with the majority of our cities now in Solano County. We know that there will be impact. What does that impact look like? The crime rate around these places, it hasn't really gone up. But what has happened is we're seeing more accidents with people who are DUI under the influence of something, alcohol, marijuana now. So we're catching up with that, and we are having impacts from that. So up about, I think, 17% is what you see, and you see that in the other states that have had it for longer, such as Colorado. Their crash rates have gone up too.
That's huge, 17%.
It's big. And so, you know, I mean, Cheech and Chong taught us that you can't get stoned and drive. So you don't want to do that, just like you don't want to drink and drive.
And how what do the police do now as far as testing? We know what they do with alcohol, but as far as marijuana, you can smell it. But there's also edibles? And I'm not an expert, Jim.
Yes, they're edibles. They have these cute little gummy bears, so you shouldn't leave them around. I've heard horror stories.
No one can do
it. and so you've got to be really, really careful. The trick is, our police officers have learned how to tell if somebody is intoxicated or using marijuana, even if you can't smell it. So if you're loaded, you react different ways. I don't know what that is, you know, from a police officer's point of view, but they're trained in that now. So they know how to do it. And the tests, I guess, are getting better, because you can do a urine test. But the problem is, for marijuana users, is marijuana stays in your system. It's fat soluble, and it stays positive in your system if you used it 30 days ago. But if you get a blood test on it, it'll show, you know, a less amount if you took it 28 days ago versus when the cop pulled you over. So there's still a lot of trick there, they're figuring out how to do it. So
that's good.
Yeah. Yeah. And that was another reason we waited, because nothing was, you know, when it first happened, it was too difficult to decipher when somebody was intoxicated from marijuana versus alcohol or some other substance.
Yeah.
Were watching our show and they were inundated by the power of Jim and they just couldn't calm down and they started driving erratically. That could happen too.
It happens. Exactly. Power of Jim, we are breaking this news here now. It has not been anywhere. I haven't even put it on my Facebook, and I usually will do that, but I've been really overtaken by a lot of other things. But this is a big story.
Mm-hmm. It's a big story. When did it happen? When did this happen?
It's been already a week ago.
Oh, really? How did it not hit the news?
You know, the news guys are, like me, blinded by COVID-19, and they don't watch for the other news. And there's big news breaking all around us, really. Yeah. And this is one of them. This is a big deal. We're the biggest city in the county that doesn't has not up until now allowed it. And so there's going to be a lot of competition for those. And the city council will decide who gets the licenses to do it. So it's going to be a really tough job. I'm not looking forward to it, but I guess it's time.
Yeah. Times, they are changing.
Yeah. Well, you know, when you think of this, it's very interesting because on the other hand, there is that other, the other side, you know, people feel like marijuana should be legalized because how's that different than really alcohol? I mean, I don't know where you stand on it. You know, it seems like there's some medicinal, like real true medicinal things, especially dealing with aging, you know? And you know, the argument is like you have things like the alcohol that, that is proven to really make people, you know, depressed and just go through a lot of moods. And there's a difference between even hard liquor versus just beer, right? Beer is associated with the party. Hard liquor kind of really plays on the moods, the emotion. People get drunk. People get killed all the time. You know, in general, of course, it can modify your, you know, just your perception of things. But on the other hand, you know, for the individual, really, it seems like, and everything that I've seen is says, points to the fact that the worst thing that can happen to individuals is that they get excessively happy. You know, there's not really that many negative things. And the argument is, well, we don't know many generations down the line, but it's very interesting. What are your thoughts about that?
Well, you know, I don't know if you guys know this about me. Maybe I haven't told you.
Oh, I know she's a 60.
I started off when I was going to college. I was going to be a doctor, and so I was pre-med. And I was down at Texas Women's University, and I got a biology scholarship, and I was a scientist. I worked in a lab synthesizing DNA so people, other scientists, could use it to study AIDS. This was the first in the early 80s when the AIDS really epidemic kicked off. And they needed DNA to do tests on. So I worked as a scientist doing that and also worked with rats doing studies. So I have a little bit of a background in this. So I really look into those kind of things. And I've looked at the different studies, and I don't think, because it's still illegal federally, we haven't had great studies here. That's the bad part about it. And the feds have decided to back off. In other words, not come in and swoop into, let's say, Fairfield and bust one of our, you know, businesses. They have put a standoffish on that. They still go after illegal marijuana sales. And that is still going on. And in fact, it's blossoming in California still.
Yeah.
So what is defined an illegal marijuana sale versus a legal one?
You have to have a permit through the state of California to sell marijuana. And if you don't have one of those permits, you're illegal.
And then to buy, you need a prescription, or is that not the case?
No. Anybody can buy if you're 18 years or older, or is it 21 now? Maybe 21 or older. And, you know, I don't know. What is that? I should know that. Hello, Kat. 21 or 18.
Well, someone will put comments below.
Yeah.
Yeah. We could Google it really fast. But, but the bottom line is that we don't want it in young people's hands. Right. Because there, even though there aren't a lot of bad effects, if you're inhaling it, it does damage your lungs like cigarettes. Sure. We know that. Right. But with it being edible, people use it a lot in nowadays, use it inside their cooking. So I have a friend who has parties over at his house. I haven't been to one, but that they infuse everything in their meal with marijuana. And so you get pretty heavily stoned when you do that. And so, but a lot of people are using it that way. They infuse it into their food. I know that elderly people, there are some of that you can get that does not give you a high, but still has the effect of easing pain. So a lot of older people are using it now for arthritis, in things, for oils and so on to put on their body. And so all of those things I think are good. And I support that. You know, if people want to do that. I'm a 70s girl, so I did smoke weed in the 70s. And I've had an edible more recently. And I'll tell you, I don't want to do it again, but it's a lot stronger than it was from the 70s marijuana that we use. This stuff is, it's scary. As I told Chuck Tim, who's a councilman here, he said, I've never even smoked marijuana. I said, then dude, you don't know what you're talking about here when you're making the law, because the law in Fairfield, because the stuff now is so strong, it scares me to death. But people, I get used to it or whatever. So, yeah. So I have experience with it. I know what it is. And people need to be careful. That's what I'll say.
Yeah. Well, it's interesting because I've seen this go on, this discussion, and, you know, a lot of people would say the medical community has a huge vested interest in not wanting something really effective, you know, per se. I mean, pharmaceutical, I'm not saying one way or the other. I have my opinions, but the whole thing is
the medical community, or you mean the big pharmaceutical?
Big pharma.
Yeah, big pharma, of course. You know.
They're buying into this stuff, though.
Well, you think about it, though, right?
Are they starting to distribute it?
And distilleries, are also going in to try to get licenses. Here's the thing, though, in Fairfield, it will still be illegal to grow here. We are not allowing that to happen here in Fairfield. You can have 6 plants for personal use inside your home. You cannot do it commercially in Fairfield. So that's one thing we're still forbidding at this time.
Mm.
So it will be brought in from other areas.
So if you're thinking of a new side hustle, this is not one of them.
Not the legal one.
It's not legal in Fairfield. As a side hustle or your primary, some people are making big
there we go.
Stuff.
Well, it's kind of funny. I have a friend that does do a side hustle of driving, and you know, of course, they have dedicated drivers for some of these dispensaries. Yes. And he's saying some cities he cannot go through because they will not allow the transporting of the marijuana through those cities. So he literally has to go, you know, as if you remember the group Supertramp, Take the Long Way Home. I mean, he had to really maneuver through those cities. He had to go a long way because that city would not let them through, you know. And if he does get caught, it could be very costly. And so it's very interesting, the control that we have.
And it's difficult because, like you said earlier, it's not the same everywhere, you know. And we have a lot of very enthusiastic marijuana folks in Fairfield, and have for a long time, who really beat us up at the city council level and argued with us and said, you don't know what you're talking about. You're a bunch of old codgers or whatever. And we just wanted to make sure that science and stats were on our side before we brought this to a legal sales position in Fairfield. And that's what we did. And I think that we did a good job by doing that. That's what I think, of course.
Yeah. Well, what do you think in terms of the populace? One thing always is a challenge for cities is just the engagement of people, right? How many people do you think will really react or respond? Of course, people that are elected, the elected officials definitely need to take a stand because they, you know, they have to act in the best interests of the people, right? Right. What about the people themselves? What do you think their response is going to be? Of course, this is kind of late breaking news.
It is.
Just what do you think their response
will be? I think people are going to be, I think we're going to hear very vocally from some people who are excited about it. I think you'll see a real split. I think people are gonna come at us and be very disappointed in us, some. And hopefully they will understand that we were took our time, we looked at it, we did hire this consultant who doesn't make any money on the outside doing sales or anything like that. I cross-examined him in public about it. I said, you're not going to make money from, let's say, somebody who wants to come in here and put a place in here now, are you? Because I will hunt you down. And Kat doesn't like when people lie to her. And she will let everybody know.
Yeah.
She has a big mouth.
And long claws.
Yeah, so, but you have to do that. You know, you don't want that kind of conflict.
Yeah, that's really true.
Yeah.
But, you know, as a whole, just how has Fairfield been responding to all the lockdown, and what are your opinions about when things may be reopened?
Well, Solano County was the last county in the Bay Area to shut down. And the officer here, the health officer who makes that call from the county, he felt that people really did know that we were supposed to be mostly staying at home. So I actually made a big stink and I went to him and publicly said, Fairfield's going to go ahead, we'll move forward and we'll shut down if the rest of the county won't. So they did it. The next day or so, 2 days later after I did that, and other people were on them as well. And since then, I think people have been pretty good. We have had some instances of people acting out. For instance, people going out and publicly playing volleyball. Our police went out. We don't arrest or do anything like that, but just to remind them, this is not a good idea, and so we need you to close down. At which point they gave our police the middle finger, along with a lot of really flowery language and a lot of F-bombs and so on. Mm-hmm. So that night, what we did was went down, took down, of course, any nets that were around and put up huge cement blocks. So there was no way they could play volleyball anymore. So, you know, we hate to have to go to that far, but we did do it. And we've had a couple of other things, but so far, so good. We've only had two deaths, which are two too many in Solano County so far. One was in Susan City, and one, I believe, was in Vacaville, although I'm not sure about that. And so far as of today, 2,015 people have been tested in Solano County, and 141 have been positive. And so that's not real big, which is very good. Currently, there are 16 people in the hospital in Solano County. Fairfield has had 35 show up positive in those 2,000 who've been tested. So, we don't have a real high rate of infection here so far, thank God. And people are doing a good job, I think. Yeah. Wow. Yeah.
Well, that's really good. Do you feel, what is your personal opinion about, I've heard about a possible resurgence of the COVID-19. Do you feel like that's a possibility?
It worries me. I don't think we're ready to reopen. I still think we need maybe a couple of weeks. But I know we're supposed to be going to the end of April, but I don't think we should go to the end of May unless the scientists say, oh yeah. But as we know now, the scientists were way off in their initial
look.
And it was outrageous. We have destroyed our economy. And so we cannot continue with this government mandated shutdown unless truly scientifically it shows that there's going to be a resurgence. I think what would be smart is to keep people who are high risk, to keep them at home. Of course, anybody who tests positive, they need to be kept at home and away from the populace. I don't believe, I'm very, very, I guess you would call me conservative when it comes to this. I don't believe you should be putting any tracking devices on people. They've talked about that. And that is a big fat no-no as far as I'm concerned. Yeah. You know, I'm not into that Big Brother business at all. And I told people I would fight them on it and probably scratch their eyeballs out if I was going to do that.
Don't mess with the cat.
No, we don't want to do that here. You don't want to violate. We've already, you know, taken away some rights of people. And for a short time,
for our safety,
tolerate it. Definitely. We're not going to do it forever.
They always say it's for our safety, but who knows?
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
And allow them to track us now, it'll never end. You know, it'll be another reason next time. Yeah.
I agree with you, both of you, on that. You can't do this forever. And you see some people, I saw a mayor in Solano County, not the mayor of Fairfield, but another mayor, say to businesses, look, it is really, we can shut you down permanently. And we think that it's a real, what did she call it? It was very interesting the way she said it. You know, like it's a real gift for us to let you have a business. That's not the way we see it in Fairfield. We feel like it's a gift if you open a business in Fairfield to the government.
Yeah.
This is not the other way around. Absolutely. This is not some kind of, you know, it's stunning to me when people decide that it's so, there's the government so important that it is a gift that we allow you to have a business. Oh, for Pete's sake. That's not the way it works.
There are people who actually believe that if it weren't for the government, then people wouldn't be in business, and then we are lucky to have the government. And the government works for us. Kat, you work for us and you know it. And you're, you know, working all night long for
I us. Work all the time.
Yes.
For, you know, as an elected person, because I believe that you are a public servant when you are elected, and that no, the government doesn't run the world. Although some people believe that, the truth is that people have to be empowered, and it only comes from people. Yeah. And all of our rights, I believe, come from God. And so that's what the founder said, and that's what I believe as well.
Yeah. Well, you know, I know, you know, in a lot of the communities, we talk really about what does it mean to really acknowledge versus support versus be engaged versus be involved.
Right.
And so all of those are really different levels in that order, right? And so really to make any significant change, you need to truly be involved. And so this is why it really is a privilege, you know, to be able to vote and to be able to take, you know, things and take action, but you got to be in the know of what's going on. So I really appreciate you bringing in just the information that we have. Again, you know, just talking about Fairfield and just its stand here in terms of the new situation dealing with marijuana, also the update with the COVID-19 and You know, there's a lot of things that are happening right now, and we're going to be catching more with Councilwoman Catherine Moy of Fairfield. And just any final thoughts from you, Catherine?
I'm really excited for us, the power of Jim, to break this news that Fairfield is now going to allow two retail operations of marijuana inside the city of Fairfield. And so I'm glad that the power of Jim is breaking this. I'm glad we're able to do that. And it shows that you're going to, the power of Jim is going to be leading on a lot of things, and that this will be the place where you want to get your information. So I'm really glad that you allowed me to break that here tonight.
Well, this is going to be really special.
Said it better.
Absolutely. I don't know. Jim, Jim Meyer.
Yes. I think that's it. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, for being here. Thank you to our very special guest, Cat Boy. And we'll see you guys next time on the
Power of Jim.
Stay tuned for Late Breaking News.